Piper, go fetch my bag. Grandma Sadie said, it's by the front door. Coming right up, I said. I ran to the front door. Grandma Sadie's bag was big and shiny, like a pillow covered in aluminum foil. It was heavy, too. I half carried, half dragged it back to her. Thank you, Pipsqueak, Grandma Sadie said. She snapped it open and mumbled as she dug around inside. Let's see. I was so excited. I felt my heart starting to beat harder. Would I get a comet rock? Or a drop of diamond rain from Jupiter? Or maybe a piece of Saturn's ring? Whatever it was definitely coming with me to show and tell tomorrow. Here, Grandma Sadie said. She held the present out to me. Chapter 4 Space Dust. Grandma Sadie handed me a small plastic bottle, the see-through kind that medicine comes in. But there wasn't medicine in this bottle. Instead, there was, well, it looked like there wasn't anything at all.
Do you like it? Grandma Sadie asked.
I can't tell what it is.
It's space dust collected from around the cosmos, she said.
What's the cosmos?
The universe.
Oh, I said, and I started to unscrew the top.
Don't do that, dear. You don't want to make a mess.
How could I make a mess with something that was practically invisible?
Don't worry,
Dad said.
Piper's been practicing with a vacuum cleaner.
Mom raised an eyebrow.
I think it's better to keep it in the bottle for the time being,
Grandma Sadie said.
All right, Pipsqueak.
All right, I said. I rocked the bottle from side to side and squinted to see the dust. We have show and tell tomorrow. I'd bring this in, but you can't tell there's anything in there. If I say it's space dust, Claire will think I made it up. Do you have something else I could bring?
That's all I brought back, Grandma Sadie said. I'm sorry.
It's okay, I said.
Piper, I think you're forgetting a couple more words,
Mom said. Oh, right. Thank you.
You're welcome, Pipsqueak,
Grandma Sadie said.
I don't know about you guys,
Dad said,
but I'm pretty hungry. Anyone else want dinner?
I do,
Grandma Sadie said.
Traveling home from the space station always makes me famished. Great. Turkey burgers coming right up.
He brought a platter of burgers to the table with all the fixings, plus sweet potato fries on the side. Mom started asking Grandma Sadie about her work.
Where'd you just come back from? I'm afraid I can't say,
Grandma Sadie said.
What are you working on?
Grandma Sadie shook her head.
Can't say that either.
Conversations with Grandma Sadie always go like this. The people at Astroblast Explorers work on a lot of super-secret things.
Do you want to stay over tonight, Mother?
Mom asked.
Piper could sleep in Tom's office, and you could take her bed.
Uh-oh. I wouldn't mind giving up my bed for Grandma Sadie, but my room wasn't exactly clean enough for her to sleep in there.
Thanks, dear,
Grandma Sadie said to Mom.
But I need to get home tonight to pack. The Astroblast Explorers are going on a trip tomorrow.
Phew.
Where are you headed this time?
Dad asked. Grandma Sadie smiled, and I knew what she was going to say.
I'm afraid I can't say. Can't blame a guy for asking,
Dad said. When dinner was over, Mom drove Grandma Sadie back to the train station, and I helped Dad with the dishes.
Hey, Piper,
Dad said.
Why don't you log on to my computer and write Grandma Sadie a little thank you email?
I told her thank you, I reminded him.
I know, but I'm not sure she knew that you meant it.
Well, dust is just dust. Dad shook his head, and I knew he was disappointed in me.
In this house, it's the thought behind a gift that counts, not the gift itself. Grandma Sadie always thinks of you, and you should be thankful for that.
Okay, I said. I'll write to her. I headed into Dad's office and sat down at his desk. Dear Grandma Sadie, I know it's the thought that counts, so thank you for thinking of me. It's nice to have space dust. If you see anything cooler than dust the next time you're in space, can you bring me some? But if you can't, that's okay too. Love, Piper. Chapter 5. Did you hear something? After that, I went to my room to get ready for bed. My slime pet was still on my desk. Actually, he looked more like a blob than a pet. His little mouth and arms had melted into his blobness. I fixed them up. There you go, I said. I changed into my PJs. Mom knocked on the door to say goodnight, and I forgot to tell her not to come in.
Oh my goodness, what happened in here?
She asked. What do you mean?
Oh, come on now, Piper,
Mom said.
I know you know what I'm talking about.
I made a little bit of slime, I admitted.
By yourself?
Yes.
In your room?
Yes.
You know better than that,
Mom said.
You're not allowed to make slime without Dad or me supervising, and all slime making is supposed to take place in the kitchen.
I knew about the first rule, I said. I didn't know the second one.
The second rule is one you should have realized without needing to hear it,
Mom said.
There's slime sticking to everything in here, even the walls. How'd you manage to get it on the walls, Piper?
I don't know, I said. But don't worry. Slime peels off. Watch. I tugged on a string of slime that was stuck to the wallpaper. It came...
We are going to pause here, and I want you to tell me, why was Piper so concerned about what the other kids would say about her space dust?